Namaste.
So, girls, do you all know the story of Ramayana?
Yes.
Who in Ramayana is your most favorite character?
Hanuman.
And what trait of Hanuman do you like the most?
I like that his tail extends so long.
Good. How about you?
I like that he never gives up and he's very strong.
I like the way that he can change his size.
That's true, yeah. And I like the fact that he's a go-getter. There's nothing in this world that's impossible for Hanuman. So today, I'll tell you the story of Hanuman and how he was born on this earth. Long, long time ago, there lived an apsara called Punchikastala. Do you all know what is an who is an apsara?
No.
Apsaras are extremely beautiful women, celestial beings who live up in the sky in the heavens amidst the gods. They are dancers in the court of Indra. So Punchikastala was one such apsara, a very beautiful woman who was also very aware of her beauty. So one day, to amuse herself, she landed on earth and she was walking in the forest enjoying the nature. There she saw a monkey-faced sage sitting under a tree in deep meditation in lotus pose and praying. She found the scene very funny that a monkey is sitting down praying to the god. She laughed loud, but the laugh did not have any effect on the sage. She then started throwing small fruits and pebbles and stones at the sage. One of the stones that she threw hit the forehead of the sage and his penance or tapasya was broken. His eyes grew open and he saw Punchikastala giggling and laughing at him throwing fruits. He got really mad, he got very angry and he shouted and he cursed Punchikastala. He said, "Oh vain woman, do you think that you are very pretty that you find a monkey praying to the god funny? The next birth you will be reborn on earth as a monkey girl and live the life of a monkey." On hearing this curse of the sage, Punchikastala came back to her senses. So she cried and begged the sage for forgiveness. She said, "Please, sage, please forgive me for being so silly and foolish. I will never do that again. Please don't punish me and put me on this earth as a monkey." On seeing Apsara cry and beg for mercy, the sage also came back to his senses and lost his anger. But once a curse is uttered, it cannot be taken back. He told Punchikastala, "Oh, dear woman, I cannot take back my words, but I can assure you that you would find the love of your life in the next birth. And to you both, a mighty son shall be born, who is the avatar of Lord Shiva himself. And when you get this son, the curse would be broken, and you would get back the form of Apsara." So saying this, the sage left the forest. And thus, Punchikastala was reborn on earth as Anjana, a monkey girl, to sage Gautama and Ahalya. She grew up and fell in love with the king of monkeys, Lord Kesari. And just like the sage had predicted, he was the love of her life. They got married and lived happily, but they did not have babies. They were both devotees of Lord Shiva, so every day Kesari and Anjana prayed to Lord Shiva for a baby. Meanwhile, in the kingdom of Ayodhya, do you know Ayodhya is the kingdom of whom?
Ram.
Correct. But Rama was not born yet. The story happens before Rama was born. So in the kingdom of Ayodhya, King Dasharatha was doing the Putra Kamekshi Yatna for getting a child. So towards the end of the Yatna, Lord Agni appeared and offered kheer or sweet payasam to King Dasharatha and told him, "Divide up this payasam among your three wives, Kausalya, Sumitra and Kaikai, and thus the three wives will bear children for you." So King Dasharatha divided up the payasam and gave a portion of the payasam to his first wife Kausalya. Second wife Kaikai got the next portion. As he was about to give the third portion to his third wife Sumitra, a bird flew down from up above the sky mysteriously, stole the payasam and flew away. King Sumitra did not have any payasam. So wives of Dasharatha, Kaikai and Kausalya, divided up a portion of their payasam and gave it to Queen Sumitra. So Sumitra got two portions of payasam, each from Kausalya and Kaikai. And later, after 10 months, Kausalya gives birth to Lord Rama, Kaikai gives birth to Bharat, and Sumitra, since she got two portions of the payasam, gave birth to twins Lakshmana and Shatrughna. So this is the side story. Meanwhile, the bird who flew away with the payasam flew far, far, far away, and the payasam got dropped from the claws of the bird. And the wind, and the god of the wind, the Pavana, upon instructions from Lord Shiva, blew away that payasam without spilling towards the forest where Anjana and Lord Kesari was living. Anjana and Kesari were just finished their morning prayers, praying to Lord Shiva for a baby, and to Anjana's surprise, she felt something on her hand. When she looked, it was a portion of the payasam that Lord Vayu had brought it to her. And all of a sudden, a voice grew from up above. It said, "Take the offering, Anjana. It has the power of the wind of God and the essence of Lord Shiva. You would soon give birth to a baby boy who is Lord Shiva himself." Anjana took the payasam and she had a beautiful baby boy months later. This boy is our Hanuman. But he was named Anjaneya then. Anjaneya means the son of Anjana. And his other names were Pavanaputra, which is son of God of wind, and Kesari Nandan, son of Kesari. Now, how Hanuman got the name Hanuman is another exciting story. Do you girls want to hear that?
Yes.
Maybe next time I'll tell you how Hanuman got the name Hanuman. So for now, this is the story of the birth of Hanuman. Did you like it?
Yes.
Okay. Namaste.
Namaste.